What's up, internet? As always, I'm Manish from RebellionRider.com and I'm back with another Oracle database tutorial. In this tutorial, we will learn how to create tablespace using SQL Developer tool. Till so far, we have seen the creation of permanent, temporary and undo tablespaces using create tablespaces statement. But today, we will learn how to create all these tablespaces by using SQL Developer. And I think you will find this process comparatively easy. So without further ado, let's get started. Here, I'm already on my SQL Developer. To create a tablespace using this tool, first you need a connection with your sys user. I have already created one and named it sys@orcl, as you can see here. If you don't know how to create a SQL Developer connection with sys user, then you should definitely read my blog or watch my tutorial number 4. For your convenience, the link for both these are in the description below. Okay, next go to View menu and choose DBA menu item. Doing so will give you a DBA panel. Okay, let me adjust it first. Let's minimize this connection panel and here is our DBA panel. In this panel, we have to add a connection. To do so, click this big green button and from this select connection window, choose the connection which you have created with the sys user. In my case, the connection is sys@orcl, which is already selected. Now hit OK. Come back to our DBA panel. We have our sys connection successfully added here. Now double click and expand it. Now from the directory hierarchy here, select the storage and expand it. Doing so will again give you a list of directory. Feel free to explore all of them. Every directory has important information. But in this tutorial, we will only concentrate on a specific directory by the name of tablespaces. Single click on this directory will show you the brief information on all the tablespaces in your system. For detailed information, you can expand this and select individual tablespace. However, we want to create a new tablespace, so for that, right click on the tablespace directory and select create new. Doing so will open up a create tablespace wizard for you. Here, come to this name text field and give your tablespace an appropriate name. It's completely user defined, which means you can give whatever name you want. Next is tablespace type. Here you have to choose what type of tablespace you want to create. Just click this drop down list. Here you have three options: permanent, temporary and undo. Choose your option here. Say I want to create a permanent tablespace, so I will choose the first option. Next we have few tabs here in which file specification is the first one. In this tab you add the data files to your tablespace or say temporary files in case of temporary tablespace. Using name text field of file specification in tab, you can assign the name to your data file. By default it says file specification 1. Let's change it to demo_dbfile1.dbf. Next text field is directory. Here you provide directory location in which your data file or temporary file get stored. It's an optional parameter. So if you do not give any location path, then Oracle will place your data file at its default directory location. But I want to put my data file in a particular directory which I have been using in all my tablespace tutorials. Next text field is file size. It's mandatory for you to specify size of your data file. Say I want my data file to be of 100 MB. For that I will write 100 here and choose M as unit. You can check this reuse checkbox if you want Oracle Engine to use an existing data file. If file already exists, then Oracle will use that file and apply the new size if you specify size or retain the original size. If the file does not exist, then Oracle ignores this clause and create the file. Next, we have another checkbox which is auto extend. Using this option, you allow the Oracle to extend the data file when it is completely filled. On checking this checkbox, you have to specify the size from which you want to extend your data file along with the maximum size to which your data file will be extended. Let me quickly set these values. Okay, done. Similarly, you can add more data files to your tablespace just by clicking this green plus button. But before adding two or more data files, just make sure you are creating a small file tablespace because big file tablespace can only have one data file. Okay, let's jump to the next tab, which is properties. The options of this tab is more tablespace type specific. This means if you change the type of tablespace which you are creating, then these options will also change. Let me show you. Let's change the tablespace type from permanent to temporary. See, things are changing. Similar with the undo tablespace. I think we are good at permanent tablespace as here we have all the options which we can easily discuss. So let's come back to our permanent tablespace and here we are. So let's start with the first one, which is file type. In this option, you decide what type of tablespace you want to create, either big file tablespace or small file tablespace. Let it be on a small file. Next is online status. We have 5 options here. I will set it on online. You can read my block to know the difference between them. In the block size text field, you can give the size for one block. It's optional, so I'm not putting any value here. Doing so will set the block size to its default. Next is logging. I will set it on no logging. Next, we have segment management and extend management option. I will set my segment management to auto and extend management to local and let it be an auto allocate. I have explained these clauses in detail in my tutorial 64, so I suggest you to watch that tutorial, link is in the description box. Let's jump to the next tab, which is default parameter. This tab is only visible to you when you are creating permanent table space. This is because table compression is only available in permanent table space. You cannot compress undo and temporary table space. Okay, clicking on this option will provide you a list of all the compression algorithm which you can apply to your table space to compress its data. I will set it on no compress. Again, it's optional. Now the last tab is DDL. Here in this tab, you can see create tablespace DDL with all the settings which you have done so far. Isn't it the same DDL we wrote in tutorial 64 on how to create permanent tablespace? Yes, it is the same, but this time we do not have to write it. Instead, we let SQL Developer tool to do all the dirty work. Now all the settings have been done, so let's click OK and create the tablespace. Tablespace created. And here is my demo tablespace which I just created. That's all you have to do for creating a tablespace using SQL Developer. Hope you enjoyed watching it. If yes, then please hit the thumbs up button and share this video with your friend on your social network. And don't forget to subscribe. You can also follow me on my Twitter and Instagram. All the links are in the description box. That's it for today. We'll catch you all soon with another tutorial. Till then, take care. This is Manish from RebellionRider.